shaking cold. These hands are meant to hold.
Thank you.
Good morning and welcome back to another episode of Cougar TV. I'm Sam Strait.
And I'm Elaine Africano. For those of you who easily lose track of time, don't forget that Mother's Day is quickly approaching.
Oh, that's right. I need to get something for my mom. Well, if you've already gotten something for your mom, maybe you should donate to Movers for Moms too.
What a great idea. We have all the details for you who are interested in the program and what they are collecting.
Let's take a peek.
Movers for Mom was brought in last year. And Eric, the owner of the Two Men in a Truck, who sponsor Movers for Moms. He contacted Principal Smith last year and presented the program about the abused women and having to move their families. So Mr. Smith contacted the security department last year and we all agreed to sponsor this program. Items that are usable are gently used clothing, perfumes, deodorants, toothbrushes, Any type of a product like baby wipes, because children are involved in this as well. Toys for kids, games. Any kind of a product you can think of that you could use hygienal-wise. No food donations, though. If you bring your donations to Coronado High School, there's a box located in the front hall next to the security desk. And when that box is full, we'll contact Eric and he'll come pick it up and bring us another one. They'll collect items for about 4 weeks, probably about a week before Mother's Day is when he comes around, or if we get a box load, we call him, he'll come pick them up. And then now right before Mother's Day, they'll make sure all the boxes and the items are collected. You know, it's a hard program and it's a hard subject. When you talk about battered wife, it's really a hard subject, and we try to get everybody to encourage to get involved in this. If we can help these females that are being abused and removed from the homes with their children, it can make their life a little bit better. Two Men in a Truck will, if you are in an abusive situation, that's all you have to do is call Eric on Fillmore here, and they're willing to come and move you for free. They have a program where they contact the police, they have an officer there for safety. They'll come with their trucks, and they'll move whatever you need to move and take you to a safe place. I would just like to encourage the school, the community, to get involved in this, guys. It's really a good program. It works well. Coronado last year was the school that collected the most items. Eric, I know, really appreciates this, and he will come and he gets them delivered to the proper places.
Goodness gracious. That's one of the most heartwarming things I've ever seen.
I agree. If you would like more information, please stop by the security desk, and don't forget to bring your donations in before May 1st.
On Friday, April 15th, GSTA led the Day of Silence. Anyone on this day could participate by wearing red tape on their torso.
Wearing the red tape advocates bullying for all students who support. Let's take a look and see how the Day of Silence went.
I'm Avery, I'm a freshman and I'm the president of the GSTA. The Day of Silence is a day in which we stand in support for those people who were silenced by anti-LGBT plus bullying. The silence is used to show how bullying affects people and just forces people to remain silent throughout their lives. Silence in this case being anything from like not being able to be yourself to not standing up for yourself and that sort of thing. Well, the Day of Silence was GSTA led, which means that all of the members of the GSTA were participating, but anyone who wanted to could have joined in. All you had to do was like go into Ms. Burr's room 221 and take a piece of red tape and a flyer showing your support. Its purpose is just like anti-bullying, anti-discrimination, stuff like that. We're generally a safe space, so part of it was like bringing that safe place outside of the school, outside of like that room, and showing people that we do have solidarity movements and that people aren't alone in their silence.
Anyway, it's that awkward part of the year when it's still snowing, but also 65 degrees.
That's right. But as the snow melts, instead of surfing the mountains, some of us have started to surf the streets. Let's take a look at some gnarly shredding.
My face.
Nice.
Hey Stan, it looks like you got some jelly on your chin or something.
Now let's send it over to Jason to see what's happening in your sports world.
Thanks, fellow anchors. Girls soccer and baseball are in full swing. Our sports team decided to swing by and see how each of the teams are doing.
Next year, we have a lot of juniors that are already playing varsity. Some have played varsity through their entire high school career. And so we're not going to have a shortage of players, but there's definitely a lot of talent in this year's senior class that we're going to miss next year. A lot of our starters are seniors, and that's going to take some adjustment. I mean, we're really working on everything. Baseball is something where you really have to keep updating your skills. You'll take steps back more than take steps forward. So hitting has been a big thing this season. We need to, against fast pitching, we need to get our bats going quicker. That's been a big focus this season. So sunflower seeds are the most popular snack for baseball. I'd say the two most popular sunflower seed flavors are cracked pepper or dill pickle, but I don't really like dill pickle. I like cracked pepper more. That's just me.
Awesome, we're good. Ballin'.
Good job, fellow Cougars, and good luck on the rest of your season, boys and girls. That's it for sports this week, Cougars. Now, back to you, Sam and Elena.
Thanks, Jason. We have another special student this week that is musically gifted. Her name is Michaela Alter, and she plays some tasty jams.
Yes, she does. Her unique combination of guitar and vocals made her the perfect candidate for this week's installment of Faces in the Crowd. Let's see what she had to show us.
Hi, I'm Michaela Alter. I am a junior at Coronado. I play guitar and sing and also write music. I've been playing guitar and singing. Well, I've been playing guitar since I was 8 or 9 years old, and I've been singing since I was like old enough to sing. I got into music shortly after my sister died as a coping mechanism, and ever since then, music started flowing through my mind and is what I prefer to do.
The past and seeing how we grown, setting our future like it's just you and me, thinking we can be forever. That's all we saw is forever. No, met you when you were lost, and I knew I'd be paying the cost in the end. Is this the end? You have mixed emotions causing this commotion in my mind. Why was it easy for this time? And why did it feel so damn right? I love you, you, I love you, you, I love you. You, I hate that I still do. Every time I look at you, I feel hate, but I feel love too. We're drifting apart, how we get so far, man. Look at us now, look at us now. We're just two people in the crowds. I'm staying up late, my thoughts are faded. How come we never made it? No, it don't feel right. Can't sleep at night. Wanna hear your voice, no, we'll just fight. But I'll still be thinking of you, thinking of me, thinking of us, and hoping you'll see before I pack my bags and leave. I want it all back, cause I feel so lost. My mind says give in, but my heart won't budge. Even then, I'll be thinking of you, and I hate it. I love you so much, I can't escape it. I love you, but you, I love you, you, I love you. You, I hate that I still do.
Wow, she's got some raw talent.
She really does, as do many of the students here. Remember, we encourage you to come down to room 5 and tell us what you've got. Who knows? You may be on next week's episode.
That's right. Well, that concludes another week of Cougar TV. Join us next week to find out what's happening in your hallways. I'm Sam Strait.
And I'm Elena Africano. Thanks for watching, and enjoy the rest of your week.
Yeah, Spider-Man and Freeze in full effect. Uh-huh. You ready, Ron? I'm ready. You ready, dude?
I'm ready, Slick. Are you?
Oh, yeah. Take it down. Girl, I must warn you. Something strange in my mind. Yeah. Yo, situation is serious. Let's cure it, cause we're running.